do you think you'll be doing in the future? Is that sort of hard to predict, or what are you currently working on, John?
Currently I'm working on a number, actually quite a few different things, but in particular I'm working on installation works, and what I call installation works, they're very contemporary artworks based on, rather than putting the various plastics behind perspex in boxes on the wall, in wooden boxes on the wall, which almost in a way are acting like paintings, because they're very much like oil paintings. From a distance they look a bit like oil paintings, and that's just the history where I come from, and it's in a way I'm just challenging that and bringing the plastics out more into the open, which I started when I started working with the totems. I started bringing the plastics and things out more into the open without being locked behind perspex up on the wall. Now I'm bringing the plastics out onto the ground, into the museum or into the gallery space, and having them mimicked by canvases up on the wall behind it, which have been digitally printed upon with an image of the plastics themselves. I'm also working in areas of public art, making public art. One aspect of that public art making, it gives me the opportunity to work on a really large scale, which is really fantastic for me. I've just been chosen to do some very large public art projects down in Coffs Harbour, and also I've been selected to make a public art piece in Brisbane, up at just next to Story Bridge in Brisbane. And these will be significant pieces. The ones, for example, the piece that I'm going to be doing in Coffs Harbour, I can only really give you a brief outline at the moment because we're at initial stages of it. However, I'll be using found objects and selected items from a site that's being cleared at the moment. So I'll be using a lot of leftover materials to make this public artwork, which will be very, very interesting for me. And I've already made the selection of the items that I want to make this particular sculpture. And whatever it does to the audience, to the art viewing public, I don't really like to guide too much other than to create the work. If it causes them to have a perceptual shift of any sort, then that's fantastic. Mm-hmm.